Hi guys, it's 5:10, Wednesday 29th of March. It's been a couple of days since I last picked the camera up, which isn't a bad thing because I don't have anything to vlog about every day of the week. Anywho, next month, some of you may be aware, some of you may not, it's Autism Awareness Month. Get my teeth in. Are they in? Yep. Good. Right. So next month I will be doing some videos. I'm not going to bombard the channel with autism related videos, but I do want to get some out there. Talking about specific traits that are common for kids and adults with autism, because I want to raise awareness for both, because it's not just kids, it doesn't go away. You know, it's not a condition that can be cured, it's not something that you'll just grow out of. It's there. And as a man that does have it, I would like to do my bit, if you like. I know I've got a young lady on my Facebook who doesn't think we need to raise awareness. She just wants acceptance, but my argument to that is, how can we expect people to accept the condition if we're not raising awareness to explain the condition to them? You know, they can't just go, oh, you've got autism, oh, okay, I'll accept that. You know, not everybody. I knew nothing about the condition until I was diagnosed a couple of years ago. Didn't even suspect it, didn't really know what it was. I'd been asked a few times on a forum if I had Asperger's syndrome, and I thought they were just joking to wind me up or something, because that was way before I got the diagnosis as well. But nope, it turns out I does have it. I does have the Asperger's. I think my mum's got the letter that proves that I got the diagnosis. I'm pretty certain I don't have it anyway. So, yeah. Moving swiftly on. I haven't done a lot today. I've been to Lidl's and Sainsbury's, which I pretty much do every day. It's probably why I don't actually, or why my money doesn't last long, because of the way I'm spending it on food. I spend, like, last time I spent it on food, and it just seems to just, boop, gone. Well, I've got a feeling it's the way I spend on food and what I buy that's doing it, so I need to sit down and change my ways, I think, and try to do some proper grocery shopping. Anyway, the only other thing I've done today is I've had a count of all of my Lego minifigures, and I have a total of 876. So getting close to 1,000. And the I think my teeth fell out again. The weird thing is, I've not even been intentionally collecting minifigures, rather, not finnies, or whatever I was going to say. They've just accumulated over the 12 years I've been into Lego. I started back with Lego in 2005. Actually, I'll say 13 years, I'll say 2004, because that's when I was in a youth hostel, and I did have some Lego back then. So, I'll say sort of around that time, 12, 13 years. So, that is a lot of figures. I did ask about it on the AFOLs of Facebook group. And if you don't know what an AFOL is, it stands for Adult Fan of Lego. So, I would be an AFOL. Anywho, like I said, I've got my Lego channel. That's where I post most of my, or all of my Lego related updates and videos. But I will say, I'll be able to go shopping later tonight. Well, hopefully after 12:30, if and when my money goes in. So, I can get that train base I need and that controller. I've got to get the controller on Bricklink, so the chances are the shop's going to have a spend limit, so I'll have to do a bit of shopping and get a few extra bits, I think. That's not a biggie. I have projects still to finish on here, like the hospital, for example, which is going to remain on hold because I need base plates. That's the next largest project to deal with. Then I'm going to modify the fire station and the hospital. But like I said, if you want to see any of those sorts of updates and videos, they will be on my Lego channel, which is called The Bricknut 30. 30, because I believe that was my age at the time when I made the initial channel. When I initially made the channel. I believe. Oh, sweaty ham. It's been a lovely day though. A little bit windy and a little bit overcast, but can't complain. Look like we had a bit of rain last night as well. Still got to find a home for that big beast. I'm planning, as I don't think I'm going to need an electric saw. I think, as these aren't very wide, that way I can get away with a handsaw, a couple of my clamps, and using this as a straight edge, so I could, you know, put that across there as like a straight edge, and use that as a guide with a couple of clamps on it. Or even the longer one, whichever. Because I can't cut straight to save my life. I really can't. I'm going to use the two longer ones and put them in this gap. I'm not going to do the L shape. In fact, I could, if I actually wanted just the one shelving unit at one end, I could just use those as battens, but I've been looking through a box that I've had under the kitchen sink for ages, which was a to sort later thing. It's down there. I've actually emptied a lot of it out. I've got all these various brackets. I think those are actually going to be too big and heavy, so I don't think I'll use those. But as the surface is going to be made up of two planks side by side, I figured something like this across the joint will help hold them together. So I've actually got a couple of these, I think. Yeah, I've got some smaller ones if I need them. I could put on the one on the inside maybe, so there'd be three of those holding the surface together and onto the two end cabinets, which I'll make first. And the shelf, I think the shelving on the end cabinets can be held with these, which I've got plenty on. Actually, no, I don't think I've got plenty of these. I may have to go and get some, because I'm going to need four per shelf. So I can do one, two, I can do three shelves with these. I could use one of these assorted brackets that I've got sitting here as well, but I don't want it to look odd. I've just got a few other metal brackets there, just in case I need to do some reinforcing, that's all. So, yeah, because the uprights, I've just remembered, are going to be made up of two bits side by side as well. That can be used to hold those together as well, so I could be doing it two jobs. I don't think I've got any flat bits. I have to do a bit of because I was thinking of putting that across the bottom to hold them together as well. So I may actually, I'll have to go to Roy's anyway, but because I'll need some more of these. And I may need to get a pack of these or something similar. I don't think I've got any anywhere else, but like I said, I just pulled out all of this stuff. I don't need that. We're back in there. Oh, ready, because I want to get it done soon, and I'm not going to use these either, am I? So, it's quite a lot of weight there. I don't want to throw them out, because they're good, strong brackets. This bag bagged up some stuff. I'll give that to Stepdad, because he's always making things that requires legs and knobs and whatnot, so I bagged those up. I'll give them to him. If he doesn't want them, he can just throw them in the bin. Right. I don't need to go in there, do I? Nope. Now that I've got my Claude Butler, the blue and silver one, up and running perfectly, it's time just to make a few adjustments to it, just to make it look a lot cleaner and tidier. Just a few parts I'm going to replace, simple parts. Like the bolts that hold the V-brake on at the rear. I'll put a couple of nice shiny ones in there. There's a couple of bits I'm going to paint. I think I've got the silver paint in there. If not, I'll just get another fresh tin of silver paint to paint those up. And what they call a brake noodle, which is that metal sort of 90 degree loop thing that you get on V-brakes that the cable go through. I'll put a shiny one of those on. Right, what I'm going to do, scratch my head. I'm going to turn the camera off. I think I'll leave it a little bit longer before I get some food. And I will switch it on later this evening. Hopefully I'll have something else to talk about. Or to show, or to do, or something. We'll see. Okie dokie, it's now nearly 11:30, so that phone might ring soon. There's no telling with Mum, because she may have fallen asleep again. Right. Here, I've got a box of bits. There's no guarantee I'm going to do this tomorrow. In fact, it may end up being Friday because I want to have a tidy up in here and the bedroom first. Because, obviously, I've got to move all this stuff over here. That's all got to be moved into the bedroom, and at the moment there's not a lot of room to move in the bedroom, so I'm going to have to do that first. I'm not worried. Oh, shut up, Discord. There we go. I'm not worried about anything up that way on the floor because I don't intend to be up that end. And I did make a slight miscalculation. Earlier I said I should only need to cut two pieces of wood.
No.
But what I'm going to do here, I hope, is demonstrate the plan. Here, I've got two planks of wood. And the idea is, to make the desk deep enough, I'll put them end to end. Like that. I do need to go and get a few bits from the department store in the morning. But I'm going to do it so this edge is facing into the room, because that's the nice edge. Yeah, it don't matter about the top, it's going to be covered. But I'm going to go with these shorter ones. I was going to go with the longer ones, which I've got here. But then I realised I'm going to have the keyboard on the actual desk itself instead of a tray like that. If I wanted to get really fancy, I could do that, but I don't. I don't want a fancy table. But anyway. So I thought I'd opt for the lower one so it's more comfortable to use the keyboard when I'm sat at it. So that's the plan. So what I will do is use one of these brackets right across there, which will do two jobs. It will hold these two bits of wood together, and I can use that to help support the top as well. And that's why I want to go to the DIY store, because I want some flat metal plates, which I can get, I think, for a couple of quid. I'll only want a couple. I think you get them in a pack of two anyway. They're not expensive. And what I will also need to do is make four of these uprights. Now, I've only got enough to make three, which isn't a problem, because I've got these two, I've got two really long ones right at the back there, then I've got these two shorter uprights here. I can cut the extra one I need of these out of one of these, and I will need an extra shelf. So I do want to put them in the bottom, you know, a proper bottom, because I'm going to cut a couple of these to fit in the cabinet at the bottom. So, what the shelves are going to do, they are going to go in. This is why I've got to cut more bits of wood. These are too long, but they're going to go in. I'll just move it again. We've got that as the side. They're going to go in like that. So, it'll just be two narrow cabinets like this at either end of the table, basically with a top on top of it. Simple. But the shelving is where these come in, because I will screw these on here like that. Obviously a tape measure, you know, have one sort of somewhere there and one at the back. Same again further down. And then the bottom one will be screwed on the two bits of trim that I'll cut out of this. And the other one, I've got two of those. So I also need to go and get some more of these, because I haven't quite got enough. I worked out I needed four per shelf, and I've got enough for three shelves, so I need another four. Because it's going to be two mounted in each. Shit. Is that the same width? Please tell me that is the same width. No, it's wider. Crap. Might have to go and get one of these shelves machined out of one of these in my stepdad's workshop, because it's too wide and I'm not cutting down the full length of one of those with a bloody handsaw. Sod that. I'll just take it to mum's and get stepdad to run it through his table saw. So it'll have one base bit missing until Monday at least, which isn't a problem. Like I said, I don't know when I'm going to start on this. I could start this one tonight, but I don't have the bracket for the bottom end. But I could have made that side up, because that is how I'm going to do it. I'm going to make each side up, work out where I need these blocks. And I've got a pot of assorted screws there. Should have enough. I've actually got cobwebs on that one. That must have been the bottom section. Right. Should have enough here. Might even have a little bit left over. I've just got to remember when I use these uprights for the top as well, I've got to put the decent side outwards as well. another bit with the plastic coating on or whatever it bloody is. The stuff that usually peels off. That was some broad Norfolk right there as well. Off. Peels off. Peels off, boy. Right. I'm actually hot. Got an hour before my money goes in. A little bit less than that. No, about an hour. I've done some calculations. In other words, I've looked at the calendar. I can just put off paying my phone bill till next payday. So I'm going to do that. Don't have to, but I'm going to. Because I want to. I was just checking the date, because it's usually round about the 15th, 16th of the following month they cut me off, so. But I need to get paid on the 13th, so it should be okay. Now I've said that, I'll probably get cut off again. If I do, shit happens. But it shouldn't. In theory, it shouldn't. I wondered how long that'd be. So I need to be awake by at least 10 o'clock. Well, I could make it 9 o'clock. But a couple of the shops that I want to go into don't open till 10 o'clock anyway, so if I said if I could wake up about 9:30, I think we'd be good. Half an hour or so just to wake up. It's usually all I need. I could get dressed and go straight out on a bicycle, but I'm usually half asleep and that's not a very safe thing to do. Goody, goody, goo! I'm going to do that in a minute and he'll turn around and bite me, won't he? Goody goody. Ah! You don't seem to mind it at the minute. So, I mean, some of those plastic blocks, I'm pretty certain my local Roy's will do those. We're going to be expensive in there, but it's probably cheaper than going to a builder's merchant. Although I don't know if a builder's merchant will do those. As it's not really a building thing, it's a DIY thing. If I can't, I've got some other brackety things through there that I can use, so it's not a biggie, but I'd rather just use all the same if I can, because it'll look better. Not that I think anyone's really going to notice, but what am I going to use to mark on that? Because that's black. I hadn't thought of that. I need like a white pen or something. Or a white crayon or something. Anywho. I'll cross that bridge tomorrow if I need to. If I need to find something or go and get something, I'll get something. Anyway, thanks a lot for watching. That is it for this video. So I'm probably going to be looking at building this desk Friday, and I will set the camera up and do some filming. But I think, as there'll be some cutting to do, I may do all that outside in one go. So I'll measure up all the shelving I've got here and just take it down and, excuse me, and do it in like one hit. I could lay them all together like that, or at least lay two together like that, perhaps do two at a time with the saw. Be quicker than doing one at a time. I have got good hand saws. It'd be even quicker if I had an electric saw, but I don't. Because I could have done it downstairs and plugged it into Victory's socket for the cleaner. Because I can open up the cupboard downstairs. Anyway. Anywho, as I said, thanks for watching. If you like the video, please give me a thumbs up. If not for me, do it for Nemo. Nemo loves the likes and the comments. And he loves you all. And I'm just talking shit, but never mind. Anyway, I'll talk to you all later. Bye.